So students, today I'm going to discuss about the preparation and evaluation of clear liquid sample. Okay, so for the preparation of clear liquid sample, the requirements are apparatus are round bottom flux, beaker, measuring cylinder, motor pistol. Okay, so these are the minimum and weight balance. So these are the minimum requirements of preparation of apparatus for the sample. So chemical requirements, these are coconut oil, potassium hydroxide, sodium mineral sulfate, ethanol, and coloring agent perfume. Okay, so these are the chemical required for the preparation of sample. Next, come to the theory part. So why we are using sample? So samples are actually, it is the cleanness of hair and scalp are among the most important personal grooming consideration. So every people are concerned about their scalp and hair. So the emphasis placed on the cleanness, it is a relatively new cultural phenomenon, and mass markets have developed. Samples have increased in importance, beginning with the soap-based products and expanding as a growing number of synthetic surfactants become available. So clear liquid shampoo may range from simple aqueous solutions of single cleansing agent and minimum of preservative and aesthetic components to more complex clear emulsions, employing several cleansing agents and a variety of modifying agents. The clarity impacts the impression of superior cleaning, a quality often attributed to clear shampoo. Because of this, samples are often packed in a clear container. Clarity and color stability are the most concern to the problem. The product clarity and usually be ensured that through careful selection of cleansing agents, additives, emulsifiers, and solubilizers. Various salts of the alkali sulfates and alkyl ether sulfates are commonly employed as cleansing agent because of their excellent solubility and low cloud point features. Control of viscosity without adversely affecting product clarity is frequently accomplished by adjusting the salt concentration or pH. Fatty acids, alkynoamides, and cellulose thickeners are also used for this purpose. So materials and makeups, come with the next portion, that is material and makeup. So the ingredients for the these are the ingredients that are required for the preparation of shampoo, that is coconut oil, potassium hydroxide, sodium mineral sulfate, ethanol, coloring agent, perfuming agent, and water. So these are the minimum requirements for the preparation of sample. So next, come with the makeups. So in round bottom flux, required amount of coconut oil is taken along with the potassium hydroxide solution and heated on the water bath up to 60 to 70 degrees. In another beaker, sodium mineral sulfate is taken as a sufficient amount of water is added to form a thick paste. On completion of the saponification, the saponified coconut oil is added to the heated SNS paste with a proper mix. The product is allowed to cool at the room temperature and alcohol, coloring agent, and perfume is added. Okay, so the product is then transferred into a suitable container and labeled inside. So this is very simple process for the preparation of sample. Okay. So students, myself Satyabrat Sharma, Assistant Professor Assam Downtown University Pharmacy Department. So today I am going to demonstrate how to prepare the sample. Okay. So these are the ingredients required for the preparation of sample. We have seen. Okay. So first is the sodium mineral sulfate, then sodium citrate, then calcium alginate, glycerin. Okay. That is glycerin. Then methyl paraben and perfume. So first of all, for the procedure, first step. So sodium mineral sulfate acts as a foaming agent. Okay. So first we are adding all the ingredients accordingly given in the required formula. According to the formula, we are adding all the ingredients step by step wise.
After that, we are adding, that is, glycerin and methyl paraben in a beaker and mix it all the ingredients properly. Okay. After mixing the proper ingredients, we got the appropriate mass of the shampoo. Okay. After that, we adding the perfume on it. Okay. And the shampoo is already prepared. So this is the simple procedure for preparation of shampoo. Next step, we are going to describe the evaluation of shampoo. Thank you.